Now we're going to spin the articles to match our keywords. Article spinning has become very popular because it enables you to create many pre-written articles with unique content to try to avoid your website being penalized for plagiarism by Google and other search engines. I'm not going to talk about article spinning itself here, but about what to do with the articles after they've been spun. Article spinning software only spins articles, that's all. To gain the maximum benefit from them, the spun articles need to be processed in a certain way, so that they are found easily by search engines and are certain not to be penalized. That's exactly what the Abacus File Renamer does. Here's the article spinner that we use at Abacus Data Systems. It's not one of our software products. We haven't developed article spinning software ourselves. There was no point, because this one does the job well enough. You can find a link to it below or on the Abacus File Renamer website homepage if you want to try it. I've already used the software to create the spin-coded text of my article. It's worth mentioning here that the more time and care you devote to finding synonyms for words and alternatives for phrases, the more varied your articles will be. I know that sounds obvious, but it really is worth making the effort to produce good results with spun articles. It needs to be done only once. Once it's done, it's done. There's a link to a good thesaurus website below, which helps a lot. I'll just point out also a couple of things I've done here, which will enable me to do some pretty slick tricks with the Abacus File Renamer later on. I've surrounded the title of this article with two colons and a space at the front, and a space and two colons at the end. At suitable points in the body of the article, I've written the word placeholder in brackets in a sentence, and surrounded the sentence with three hyphens and a space at the front, and a space and three hyphens at the end. They don't have to be colons or hyphens. They can be any symbols I want, as long as they're unique for the purposes that you'll see later. Now I'm going to mass rewrite the original article into 456 unique spun versions, the same as the number of keywords in my list. I click the Mass Rewrite Article icon, and type the article's name, Web Site Security, and browse to the folder on my computer where I want the spun articles to be created. I'll change the default 10 articles to 456. I click the Rewrite button and wait a few minutes. Now I have 456 articles, each one with different content. As you see, they are numbered automatically from 0 to 455 after the file name we specified. Let's just open this one and another one at random. Now you can see exactly what spun articles look like, uniquely different versions of the same article. An understanding of website security issues. Website security considerations and evaluation. It is unfortunate, but there are several ways in which website security can be compromised. An unfortunate fact is that there are a lot of ways in which website security can be endangered. This helps considerably to raise your search engine rank if you're going to flesh out your website with these unique content files and have Google think that yours is an authority site. If, however, you leave these file names as they are, it will be patently obvious to Google that these web pages have been created artificially. It'll be unlikely that your site will be found, and you'll have wasted your time. Google might even remove your site from its index altogether, perhaps never to reappear. The solution is very simple, but very, very, very time-consuming and tedious. You need to rename all these files with meaningful file names relevant to their contents. That's so important that I'll repeat it. Meaningful file names relevant to the file's contents. How are you going to do that? Are you going to change every one of these file names individually by hand to something different yet relevant? If you want to experience several of the most boring days of your life, go ahead and do that. We are going to do it the quick and easy way. We are going to rename these article files with the keywords we've found by using the Abacus File Renamer tool. Just select and copy the folder name . Paste it into the folder box of the Abacus File Renamer software and type or browse to the keywords.txt file we created. All you do now is click the Abacus File Renamer Change button, and in a matter of a few seconds, all of those 456 files were renamed. If you miscount, and there happen to be more files than keywords, just delete the surplus files. Renaming your spun article files with relevant keywords and connecting them with your homepage by a sitemap file will almost certainly help to propel your website to a higher position in search engines. In this video, we've seen how to do the first stage of the process, renaming the files with the keyword phrases that visitors actually search for. Watch the next video to see how to change characters in file names.